Pull-ups versus chin-ups, which is better for you? What variation do you prefer and why? Comment now before watching. Before we talk about the differences between pull-ups and chin-ups, here are the similarities. The following primary muscles are worked with all vertical pulls: the trapezius and rhomboids, the posterior deltoids, teres major and teres minor, and of course we can't forget about the big bad latissimus dorsi. Because we're performing both shoulder extension and adduction, back and scapular muscle growth is going to be largely similar. Let's cover the pull-up basics, including the strengths and weaknesses. The pronated grip is an excellent variation because everyone is flexible enough already. The average person doesn't need to stretch their body in preparation for pull-ups. Pretty much everyone can start doing pull-ups without special warm-ups or mobility preparation. Improving at tucked elbow pull-ups is perfect training for muscle-ups. Strength and power gains from pronated pull-ups are going to translate really nicely to strict form muscle-ups. Doing our pull-up training is also an investment in long-term calisthenics mastery. One-arm pull-ups demand strength with a pronated grip and a tucked elbow technique. Once again, we get better at what we train. Strength gain and strength transfer is no accident once you understand the basics of calisthenics. Remaining strict with weighted pull-ups is arguably harder compared to other variations. Heavy pull-ups at a high intensity have a tendency for sloppy technique. We're more likely to swing, lurch, and succumb to sacrilegious kipping when tired. Thanks to being more back than arm dominant, pull-ups are inherently harder. The increased challenge isn't a deal breaker. It just means we need to train honestly and be a bit more patient. It's time to discuss the classic chin-up. Let's talk about the pros and the cons. The supinated grip offers numerous strength and size benefits. A palms facing up technique is excellent for bicep growth. The biceps are fully contributing as an elbow flexor during forearm supination. This pulling technique should be an obvious option for anyone that's interested in bigger arms. Pausing at the top is more manageable as well when it comes to chins. This is useful for developing dominant lockout strength. A massive advantage of chin-ups is the ability to use strict form. Anecdotally speaking, making gains with weighted chins is more sustainable long-term. Technique, tempo, and weekly progress happens in a more predictable and repeatable fashion. Seeing greater improvements in sets, reps, load with weighted chins versus pull-ups is a common calisthenics situation. What do you think? The big picture concept worth understanding is the grip chosen determines results. Supinated chin-up training improves strength in this grip and pulling pattern. If your goal is the one-arm chin, choose grip wisely, be consistent, and work your ass off. Elbow pain and potential injury is the biggest downside when it comes to chin-ups. The supinated grip using a bar demands adequate upper body mobility. We need a decent amount of shoulder flexion, shoulder external rotation, and forearm supination for safe reps. The biggest mistake people often make is continuing to train through pain. Instead, opt for a neutral grip. Palms facing each other is a hybrid between pull-ups and chin-ups. The neutral grip is a happy medium for vertical pulling. It's great for developing general strength. This technique requires the least mobility compared to pronated pulls and supinated chins. Alright, let me help you decide which equipment is best, rings or bar. For anyone who's dealing with elbow pain, rings are definitely the answer. Because the rings are free to move, your body is going to naturally use a technique which feels comfortable. Joint and tendon strain is minimized when using non-fixed equipment. This reduces the likelihood of overuse injuries. Basically, if you're rehabbing or want to minimize injury risk, many people swear by rings for pain-free pulling. Everyone watching, listen to me. Avoid training through tendon or joint pain. Instead, find an exercise variation which is comfortable. Don't forget, we can't get stronger or build muscle when hindered by aches and pains. For those of you with sufficient mobility and are pain-free, bar training is an excellent option. Producing force will always be greater on a fixed surface compared to a movable surface. Go ahead and visit fitnessfaqs.com for the number one training programs, and I'll see you all very soon.